It is. Okay, yes.
A bit of a mimic here, don't
you? Oh, yeah, I am. I'll be all right. Just seeing all the people for the first time.
Yeah, no, everything's right. That's what's going on right now.
Some
of
people couldn't come because
they're
all different countries, so
it'll be challenging. Yeah, I mean, we just sort of started with COVID, it's been good.
Yes, it is.
It's
been
too started,
Thank you.
works there. That's good to know. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks, Ben.
And a very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Just before we start, if you do have a mobile phone, would you kindly switch it to silent or preferably to off? God bless you.
people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard. Till their hearts be satisfied, I will spend my life through them.
I'd ask you all please to be seated for a moment. Welcome to this funeral mass for John Patrick O'Rourke. My name is Vince Casey. I'm the parish priest here, so welcome to Our Lady Star of the Sea here at Terrigal. There's lots of things going on this morning. We're here to acknowledge and celebrate John's life, and that'll continue in the wake afterwards. We're here also to sadly say farewell. So as we share the stories about John's life, let's also share our sadness and our grief together. And we're here as a community of faith to pray for John and pray for ourselves also, whatever is needed. So all those things are going on, just let them happen. We begin our service with very simple action of sprinkling John's coffin with holy water, reminder of the day he was baptized. On that day he became a child of God, a son of God. He lived his whole life as a child of God. So we start the service with this simple prayer in action.
Mm-hmm.
now just as a symbol or a sign, two symbols or signs of John's life, White Carmel to bring up a colour red. I understand it was John's favourite colour. And his rosary beads, a simple sign of his faith. Thanks for that, Carmel. Let's stand now and turn our minds and our hearts to our God in prayer for John. O God, in whom sinners find mercy and saints find joy, we pray to you for our husband and father, our father-in-law, grandfather, brother, uncle and friend John, whose body we honour today with Christian funeral rites. Grant that he may be delivered from the bonds of death. Admit him to the joyful company of your saints, and raise him on the last day to rejoice in your presence forever. We ask this and make all our prayers through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated now. We'll have our readings from Scripture, and Pam, John's sister, is going to read the first reading for us. Thanks be to God.
The response: the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Please stand now and we'll say the gospel acclamation together. Alleluia, alleluia. Happy are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labours, for their good deeds go with them. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me.
In my Father's house there are many rooms. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I'm going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated now. Sadly, I didn't get to know John, but from the glowing reports I've heard, he's a man that with Paul, who wrote to Timothy, he can say that I've fought the good fight to the end. I've run the race to the finish. And most importantly, I've kept the faith. For all of us of faith, there's that sense that we live our life to the fullest now, but death is not the end. For Paul, there was more. He talked about the crown of righteousness that he would receive. And Jesus talks about having a room in the Father's house. Probably Jesus' description is the most detailed we have. We don't know too much about what this life, this existence after death is. But from Jesus, we get this sense of being in the Father's house. And don't get too physical about it. It's about being in a relationship with our God, and an intimacy, a familial relationship, a love relationship like we have with the people we live with, the people in our home. That's the way God wants us to be, each one of us, for all eternity. Our hope, our trust is that that's where John has gone now, to be with his Father in heaven, to be in that intimate relationship. And for people of faith, for ourselves, as we say farewell to him, there's a wonderful comfort in that John is now with his God. And when it's our turn to go to the room prepared for each one of us, John will be there to greet us, to make sure we feel at home, that we're welcomed into the Father's house, and that intimacy, that love relationship is easily there because John is there. So today is not a final goodbye. For us, for people of faith, we hope and trust in the words of Jesus. And today is an until we meet again. We look forward to that day with hope and trust. We now have our prayers of the faithful. So I'd ask Alan, Peter and Brian, some of John's brothers, to come forward to read that. And everyone, please stand. God of love, we gather with confidence in your mercy and love at this time of sorrow, and we ask you to hear our prayers.
Lord, we thank you for the time you gave John to us as a loving husband, father, father-in-law, grandfather, brother and uncle. May he now share in the fullness of life and rest in peace. Lord, hear us.
We pray to John's family, past and present. Fill the emptiness in their hearts with the presence of your love. Lord, hear us.
We pray that we may take example from John in practicing the virtues of love, tolerance, acceptance, loyalty, and generosity, which he displayed throughout his life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those gathered here today. May their togetherness bring a deep sense of hope and peace and lighten each other's burdens with love and laughter. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray with thanks for all those who have cared for John during his illness, for all those who showed such kindness and compassion to John. May God give them the strength to continue in their good works. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear the prayers of those who trust in you.
Guide us when we are in doubt, and help us when we are in need, and protect us when we are afraid. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated now. We'll continue with the prayer of the Mass, and Kevin, another one of John's brothers, and Mary Ann are going to bring the gifts forward for the celebration. Please stand now and pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you, Lord, these sacrificial offerings for the salvation of your son, John, we beseech your mercy that he, who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour, may find in him also a merciful judge through the same Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you. Let's lift up our hearts and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned. Those saddened by the certainty of dying are consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for us in heaven. And so with the saints and angels, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel or be seated now. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread. And giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Anthony our Bishop, the clergy, and all your people. Remember your servant John, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Please stand now. And formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always. And let's share a sign of peace with those near us. Together, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel or be seated now. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We'll now have Holy Communion. When the ministers get into place, I invite you to come down in two lines down the centre and go back along the sides. If you're not Catholic, I haven't been to communion for a while, not sure what to do, please come forward. Just place your hand on the chest, your chest, so the minister can give you a blessing. Grant, O Lord, that your faithful son John, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're coming towards the end of our service here at the church. When we leave the church, just before the hearse drives away, we'll gather around for a final prayer. And then you're all invited to the Breakers Club to continue sharing stories about John's life. That's where there'll be some photos of his life. I was told the reason is the club that the O'Rourke family are very vocal, and there'll be comments going with the photos. So we look forward to hearing some of those comments. But now we have our final prayers of farewell. Before I go into them, let's just take a moment to recognise that we're coming to the end of the service, and have a time of silence where we say our farewell to John, or maybe our prayers to God for John or for ourselves. Let's just use this time well. I invite you all please to stand. And join with me in the words of an ancient prayer of farewell. The response we'll all say together is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Our final prayer, commending John to the Lord before we take him from the church. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother John, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, John will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the many blessings which you bestowed upon John in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to this your faithful Son, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with John again forever. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. John, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the saints and martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. And invite the funeral directors to come forward now to prepare the coffin, and we'll all follow the coffin out and gather around the hearse.